Long ago, there was a kingdom by name Kosala. It was a fertile land. The king of Kosala was a good man, but he was fond overmuch of hunting deer. Once in 2 days, he gathered his men and went for a deer hunt. As usual, one day the king sent his men to arrange for people for going on a deer hunt.
Hi, man. What are you waiting for? Start early. The king is waiting for you.
But I have to sow my field today.
My cows have to be milked.
My child has to be taken to the school today.
How dare!
If you disobey the king's orders, you will be put to death.
The villagers had to follow the soldiers. On returning that night, the villagers had a discussion.
This deer hunt is becoming a pain day by day.
All our work is disturbed.
Let's think of a way out.
The next day, all the villagers met in a common place to find a solution.
If the forest is near, we need not spend so much time going in and coming out.
The king goes only to hunt deer. If we could bring all the deer here, our problem would be solved.
What do you mean?
Let's make a deer park.
But where?
In the small woods nearby.
We could dig a lake there, make a fence and strong gate.
Wonderful idea. Let's work on it from today.
The villagers worked hard to get the deer park ready in 2 months' time.
Look, the lake is dug and filled with rainwater.
And there is enough grass for several deer to graze.
But how do we get the deer here?
We must go to the jungle with clubs and sticks.
Beat the bushes till the deer come out of hiding.
We will drive them to the deer park and close the gate.
On the appointed day, the villagers set out to gather the deer. Armed with weapons and accompanied by loud music, the group entered the jungle. A wise young deer by name Nandia saw the mob.
These men appear to be hunters. I must try to save my father and mother at any cost.
He rushed to his parents.
Behind the shrub. When the men come in this direction, I will run ahead and the hunters will chase me. I will escape somehow.
Dear, don't risk yourself.
We don't mind getting caught instead. Mother, don't worry. I will escape somehow.
As he had guessed, when he ran out of the bushes, the hunters did not search the bushes. Instead, they chased Nandia towards the deer park.
Good! My parents are saved!
Nandia's parents were very much upset. The villagers rushed to the king to tell him the good news.
All of you look thrilled. What's the matter?
Your Majesty, we have built a new deer park for you.
We have gathered several varieties of deer in the park.
From now on, Your Highness need not go to the forest for hunting.
It's surprising to hear the great news. I appreciate your affection for me.
The king gave a big treat to all the villagers for their efforts. The deer gathered in the deer park realized that their fate was sealed.
We are all destined to be killed sooner or later.
The king comes and kills one of us every day.
An old deer in the group suggested an idea.
Dear friends, instead of dying in fear every day, let's assign turns. We will face death one by one.
All right, this seems to be a better idea.
Nandia's turn was yet to come. He spent his days peacefully grazing in the park. But his parents in the jungle missed him a lot. One day, they met a traveler going to the deer park.
If you're going to the deer park, I request you to pass on a message to our son who's there. Will you do it?
Certainly. Tell me, what should I do?
My son Nandia is there. Tell him that his aged parents long to see him.
Don't worry, I will inform your son.
After reaching the park, the traveler inquired about Nandia.
Who's Nandia here?
It's me!
Your aged parents long to see you.
I can even jump over the fence and go, but I will not do so.
Why not?
I'm indebted to the king for feeding me so long. I also have a bond with the other deer here. I just can't run away.
Do as you wish.
A few days later, Nandia's turn came to face the king. Nandia stood before the king. The king was surprised to find the deer standing in front of him.
Every day the deer run helter and skelter when they see me. But this one is standing like a rock. How strange.
The king stood with surprise, gazing at Nandia.
Your Majesty, why are you not shooting your arrows on me?
Aren't you scared?
No, it's my duty. My friends trust me, and I should face your arrows for their sake. Shoot at me, Your Majesty.
I cannot.
May I know the reason?
Admiring your strength and braveness, this arrow hesitates to hit you. Forgive me.
Great King, I request you to free the other deer in the park too.
I will free everyone. I will not harm even the other animals in the forest.
Nandia came near the king and kissed his feet. The next day, there was a public announcement.
Listen carefully, dear citizens. Hunting of animals is henceforth banned in this kingdom.
The animals were very happy and thanked Nandia. Nandia met his parents, came back and stayed with the king forever.